दर्शन मात्रेण मन सह स्यात् प्रसन्न।
यस्य दर्शन मात्रेण मन सह स्यात् प्रसन्नता। दैट हूज विजन अपीजेस द माइंड स्वयं भूयात धृति शांति। पेशेंस एंड पीस स्टार्ट सर्फेसिंग ऑन इट्स ओन। बाय अटेनिंग सच अ मास्टर द डिसाइपल इज सेट फ्री फ्रॉम द बॉन्ड्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड। Shukdev ji, in the same way, he was not too old, 12 years, 15 years. See how many young sages and monks have attained the realization of Brahman or the Supreme Self. Ashtavakra attained self-realization in his mother's womb. Raman Maharshi also attained realization of Supreme Self at a very young age. 16 years old Sulbha attained realization of the Supreme Self. And she indulges in a scriptural debate with Janak. This incident is narrated in Mahabharata. It is not necessary that one needs to be of the same age to attain Brahma Gyan or realization of Supreme Self. It is not important that one must have read scriptures for attaining Brahma Gyan, that one must have worldly knowledge. A person who has capacity for discretion, who has curiosity, a strong desire to find the truth, such a person becomes overwhelmed by attaining this ultimate gyan. Anyone who sees such a person becomes blissful, attains peace automatically. Therefore, in the context of the darshan of such great Brahmagyanis or self-realized saints, it has been said, O my Gurudev, O noble master, O Jeevan Mukt Fakir, even if you do not speak any words of comfort, and if you just keep sitting, the atmosphere of the gathering will change. This stumbling heart will also gather. That our mind and heart keeps falling in worldly fascinations, in lusts, in vices, in attachments, in ego. With the darshan of such great pious men, our mind gets inclined towards God. When one looks at the policeman, so one gets reminded of the police station. And when one sees the lawyer, then one gets reminded of the court. When one sees the nurse, one gets reminded of the nursing home. When one sees the doctor, one automatically gets reminded of the dispensary or the hospital. When you see a teacher or a professor, you get reminded of a school, college and university. But when you see a saint, then you remember God. And when you see a true disciple, a Satshishya, then you undoubtedly get reminded of the true master or the Sadguru. Sadguru mera surma kare shabd ki chot, mare gola prem ka hare bharam ki kot. It is only illusion in our mind that we are considering this world as real or true. It is all an illusion. The world appears full of happiness, full of joy, meaningful, eternal. All that we feel about the world, it is our illusion. In reality, the world is senseless. It is transient. It is full of miseries. It is fleeting and short-lived like a bubble. Pani kera bulbula, as manush ki jaat. What is the fate of this human body? Who knows what will happen tomorrow? There was an earthquake in Bhuj. The day the earthquake occurred, a day before, did people know that there will be an earthquake the next day and so many people will die? Someone may have been resting in his flat. Someone may have been working in his office. Someone may have been keeping jewelry in her bank locker. Someone may have been taking it out from the bank. Someone may have bought a plot and must be planning like, I will build a house like this. I will make such a design. I will do this. I will do that. God knows what all plans people might have made. But what is certain in this life, the life is not forever. The breath will stop one day. One will stop living one day. Anityani Sharirani Vaibhavo Neva Shashvatah. नित्यं सन्निहितं मृत्यु कर्तव्यो धर्म संग्रहः। That the body is temporary and that glory is also not eternal. Death is coming closer day by day. So meditate and contemplate on the impermanence of the body. If the mind is not focused, then chant Hari Om and sit in Padmasana, face east or north direction and meditate on Omkar or Swastik, or on the photo or idol of Sadguru, or on the picture of any saint whom you revere and on whom you have faith and devotion. Meditate and focus deeply on the photo of such a saint. It's called Tratak. Close the eyes and absorb the reflection of the Brahmaveta while meditating on the third eye or Agya Chakra. Just like a worm, when meditates upon a spider, becomes a spider. Just like that, an individual soul, when meditates upon the Supreme Soul or the Brahma, becomes the Brahma or the Supreme Soul. Likewise, the disciple, while meditating on his Sadguru, absorbs and assimilates within him the knowledge of the Sadguru.